Hi, for those that don't know me, my name is Peter Moss and I play the ukulele. I've been playing it for quite a few years. And since I'm locked down, as is everybody else, I've decided to make some good use of time by offering some free tutorials with the ukulele. And basically, it's people that belong to ukulele groups, clubs, societies. And generally, most people are using the same ukulele songbook with a different cover on it. So what I tend to do is have a look at the book and find popular tunes within it and add a few embellishments here and there just to make them a bit more fun, really. So why play three chords when you can play a dozen? Well, that's how I do it in my book anyway. Adds a little bit of spice, let's put it that way. Now, to help you along with this lesson, if you pop the pause on, in the description you will find a worksheet that has everything to do with today's lesson. What are we going to be doing? We're going to be looking at the seasonal tune, I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas, made famous, of course, by Mr. Bing Crosby. So if you haven't done it already, press the pause, print off the sheet and join me for the next segment. Before we crack on, let me explain one or two things on the worksheet. Hopefully you've just printed off. At the top half is more the sort of standard version, which you would have played if you played this tune from your ukulele songbook. And below it, you're going to find all sorts of colours with some fancy chord names, perhaps some you haven't even played before. So this is going to be a little bit of a challenge, hopefully not too much. I want to make it fun at the end of the day. So let's grab the sheets, grab yourself a bit of paper as well, tune your ukulele up, and let's start with White Christmas. Right, are we ready then? So you should have your bit of paper and we're going to be looking at the top two paragraphs, okay? We'll look at the coloured bits afterwards, but so why don't you sing and play along with me just as a little bit of a warm-up. Are we ready? Here we go. One, two, three, go. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the tree tops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. Dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmas is be white. So it's a great little tune, isn't it? So I just did the first two verses with the very basic chords. We're going to take a short break there. When we come back, we're going to see what we can do to add a few embellishments and make this a little bit more spicy. Take a break. There. Right, before we get stuck in, a quick explanation about one or two things that's on the sheet. Now, you've noticed underneath the dotted red line, all my version is got lots of different colours on it. However, the colour coding might be to everyone's advantage because the first one that we're going to make a little embellishment to is the D minor. And if you have a look on the top line where it says D minor 7th and it's got like a yellow shading around it, okay? But you'll also notice that it's in three other places if you look at the sheet. So you know that once you've learnt it once and you've got three other times to play it, you've already learnt it. So it's not like there's going to be 50,000 chord changes. There isn't. A lot of repeats are going to take place. So let's backtrack then to that D minor 7th as it is there. And what we're going to do is build it. OK, so now most people do know the chord of D minor. If you don't, here it is. If you can't quite see my fingers here, have a look on the screen and I'll show you a graphic of D minor. However, it's called D minor 7th, and the way we do that is we need to do a combination of things. We need to hold the D minor with these fingers, with normal fingers, but with our pinky, we need to be on the first string, 3rd fret. So in effect, if I take that D minor off and leave my pinky where it is, have a look what I'm doing. I'm left with a C major, aren't I? Yeah. So basically a D minor 7th is a combination of a C major, played with your pinky this time, and then a D minor using the normal fingers you would for a D minor. And this is what it should sound like. Okay, if yours sounds like that, you've got it. If not, start again. So very quickly, D minor and a C with your pinky. Put them together. D minor 7th. Okay, so where does that fit in? So our first chord is the chord of C, and we're going to hold it for 8 beats. By the way, everything that's got like times by it, like times 8, times 4, times 3, whatever, are the number of strums that we're actually going to do on each chord. Okay, so it says C for 8, so I've got I'm dreaming of a... Just to prove it, I'm going to count it. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It works. Yeah, okay, you have to trust me. And then we got that D minor 7th. And here it comes. It's D minor 7th for 4 before we say the word white. So we've got white. Okay, so white. Just like that. So, should we try that together then? I'll count 4 in and we'll do all of the top line. Starting with our C, you may as well play the C with your pinky to start with. It's just going to make it a lot easier for you to get to the D minor 7th. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm dreaming of a white.
Just add something more to it. Having that little... C in there as well. Okay, so have a practice of that. I'll be back in just a tick. Right, so one line down, not many to go. Come on, we can do this. So the next line has got in green F sharp 7th. Now that sounds very scary if you haven't played it before, but the way I try and write these things is with a little bit of logic. So for example, remember when I said at the beginning to play the C with your pinky for I'm dreaming of a, then D minor 7th, all I have to do is pop the D minor on and I've already got D minor 7th. Well, the same thing is going to happen to the F sharp 7th. However, this isn't F sharp 7th at the minute, and it's going to be soon, so be patient. What I want you to do is look at where all your fingers are, okay? So it's on the screen if you can't see my fingers, okay? What we're going to do is move one finger. The one finger that you're going to move is your ring finger. You're going to move it from the 2nd fret to the 3rd fret. I haven't moved anything else, okay? So one more time, I've gone from the D minor 7th, I've looked at my ring finger on the 3rd string 2nd fret, I'm going to leave all the others where they are, and I'm going to lift just the ring finger. Now, that is F7. We don't want to play F7. However, we are going to play that shape, okay? And can be used all over the fretboard. Do you know why? Because it's what's called a movable chord. Because if you think about it logically, you're covering every single string. Yeah. So in theory, you should be able to move up one. Yeah. And that's exactly what I want you to do. That F7 becomes F sharp 7th. Should sound like this. Now, remember when I said to you where after the chords, I've got times and then a number. We're only on it for one strum. OK, so it's F sharp 7 times 1. OK, so crisp. OK, to get the muss of Christmas, we're going to take this up another one. It then becomes G7, an inversion of G7. OK, so... If I'm doing Christmas together, we've got Christmas. So notice there's two on that one. So I've got one on the F sharp 7, one, one, two. Let's stick with it because we'll finish this line off. We're going to then go take this back down again to the F sharp 7 and we're going to strum it for one. Okay, that sounds like this. One, two, three, four. Do you want to do that with me? Starting with the F sharp 7. One, two, three, four. Okay, it sounds weird when you're not playing the rest of the piece, but believe me, it will fit. So perhaps what we should do is start from the very beginning and get to the end of line two. So starting with the C with your pinky, okay? One, two, three, four.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Makes sense, doesn't it, when the lyrics are there? Do you want to do it with me? So starting with C with your pinky. One, two, three, go.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Okay, so because that's a little bit complicated, you might need to practice it. Remember, all chords following other chords, you only need to move one finger. So, for example, we were on the D minor 7, remember? We lifted up our ring finger to make the F7. That isn't the chord we want, but the next one up is, which is the F sharp 7. Then up to G7, and then back down to F sharp 7. Take a short break there. Okay, before we go on to the third line, let's play the first two lines again together. Then I know you've got it. Starting with the C with your pinky. A one, two, three, four.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
We're now on the third line, two lines down. Okay, the next one is F and C. So I've just finished this F sharp seventh. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this finger off, which is the ring finger, and I'm going to slide everything down one fret. And that is F and C. Let me move this finger out of the way. It's doing absolutely nothing. The ring finger, okay? So what have we got there? F and C. So we've got a chord of F, using the same fingers we would for F, and we're going to play a C, but we're going to play the C with our pinky. So let's go backtracking on that then. So we've last chord we played was the F sharp 7. So we're going to take off the ring finger and slide everything down. Okay, I'm going to play it from the beginning without singing, just so you can hear how the chords actually fit in. So starting with the C with the pinky. One, two, three, four.
I'm
Yeah, so it wasn't that easy to go from there. Take a finger off, drop everything down. We're already there with F and C. Let's carry on this line. So,
just like the...
Then a regular G7 for four, for two.
Once I...
Now, the next chord is one of my favourites of all time. It's got quite a complicated title. It's G augmented 7. Now, since you've got that G7 on, I'm going to get you to keep this on, OK? And we're going to add another finger. Which finger are we left with? We've only got our pinky, haven't we? So we're going to go to the third string, one, two, three, and the third fret. Okay, G augmented seventh. What a lovely chord that is. And we're going to hold that for two actual beats. So the chord before it is the G7 for two, followed by the G augmented seven for two. Together sounds like this. I'll do that again. Three, four. Yeah, one more time. Three, four. Okay, now you might be thinking, well, why on earth have I got this finger on here that's lower than this one because this is blocking it? Well, I just want to make it easy, that's all. So you've got your G7 shape, you already know. Leave that on, okay? And just stick that one on top. Okay, so what does that line sound like with the F and C, then to the G7, and then the G augmented 7th? Okay, so that sounds like 2, 3, 4. Goes through fairly quickly, doesn't it? So F and C for 4, G7 for 2, G augmented 7 for 2. Should we do it together? Come on then. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, isn't that nice? So we're going to go, I think, from the very beginning now, just so we can remember what we did. How many of you can remember what we did? I hope I can. Right, go on then. From the beginning, C with our pinky. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm dreaming of a white...
Here we go.
Christmas. Just like the ones I used to.
So that G augmented 7 is when we say used to.
Used to.
Doesn't that sound nice? Love that chord. Okay, so because it's quite critical you get those right, I'm going to leave you with that just to practice. Pop the pause on and join me in the next segment. So we're on line 4 already. Yes. Okay, so let's have a look at line 4. And it starts with a regular C major. Use whichever finger you want. I'm going to use that one for now. Okay, so it wants 2 on C. And then it's C major 7th is next. Okay, and all I have to do to get a C major 7th is slide this down 1 fret. Sounds like this. Yeah. What's the next one? C6. Couldn't be easier. C6 is our open tuning, so that would mean no fingers at all. Just backtracking those 3 chords then we have. Okay, now to finish it, I'm going to go back to the C again for 2. So this is what we've got. Yeah, do you want to do it with me? 1, 2, 3, go. Right, I think what we should do is go back to the beginning again. Let's build it bit by bit like a jigsaw. Starting with our C right at the beginning with our pinky. A 1, 2, 3, go.
I'm dreaming of a white...
Here we go.
Christmas. Just like the ones I used to know. Where the...
Yeah, so the last 2 of that C is where the, yeah? So I'm going to do that again. 1, 2, 3, go.
I'm...
Isn't it? Okay. Have you got that? Take a short break. Back in a sec. Terrific. Right. So we're going to do 3 lines in one now. The last 3 lines of this verse starts with treetops, if you can find your place there. So we've got C for 4 strums. So tree,
tops.
Then it says C13. Now, some of you may have never played this chord before, but it's a lovely chord. How do you get to it? Well, it's very similar to another chord shape, and that chord shape is A major. How many of you have played an A major? Probably most of you, okay? I don't want you to play an A major, though. I want you to play the A major shape, and I want you to take it up one, Okay, simple as that. No bar, no blocks, nothing. So take the chord shape of A major, upper fret, and there is C13. Sounds quite weird if you play each string individually. However, when you put it in context, it works really well. So I'm going to go from treetops, that's C major, treetops. One, two, three, four. Treetops glisten, and so it's the sun has got that lovely A note in. And that's perfect with the C, the C7, the C13. It works just well. Okay, so do you want to do that with me? Treetops. So four in, C. One, two, three, go.
Treetops glisten. And
now here's one of our repeated chords, F plus C, do you remember? So we had an F major and a C together. Okay, so is that children? It is.
Children.
Now we're going to change from F and C to F minor. How do we do it? Okay, so there's the F plus C, and we're going to literally move these two fingers like that. If you can't see what I'm doing on the screen, have a look on the graphic, okay? Okay, that is F minor. So we've gone from there to here. Might want to practice that a couple of times. So on both chords, you notice that the pinky has remained as if we're playing a C at the same time. So F plus C, and the F minor has got a C in it as well. So if we go from treetops, so that's four in on the chord of C. One, two, three, go.
Treetops glisten, and children listen to.
Let's carry on here. So we're going to do C again. So we may as well use our pinky still because it's already there. So here. Then A minor, just one finger on the top of the ukulele, string four, fret two.
Sleigh bells in the.
Then the D minor seventh. Remember the D minor seventh? It's D minor and C together. There we go.
Snow.
Then to finish this off, we're going to do G augmented 7. If you remember, pop the G7 on first and add on that extra finger. So we've covered quite a lot, haven't we, in this last section. So let's go back to treetops, okay? I'm actually going to say treetops and then stop singing just so you can hear the chord changes. Four in. One, two, three, go.
Treetops.
Do you like those last two chords? I really do. I like that change. So we've gone from D minor 7th to G augmented 7th. Okay. Now, you'll find that a lot of these chord sequences I'm playing in this key that you can use actually in other tunes as well. So nothing's ever wasted. Okay. So why don't we do that together then? So from treetops, we're going to sing this time, starting with the chord of C. Treetops. One, two, three, go.
Treetops glisten, and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Okay, I think we should do all of the first verse. Are you up for it? Come on, we can do this. All right. Starting with C, with our pinky. How many times have I said that? Somebody count it and tell me at the end. C with a pinky. One, two, three, go.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the tree tops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Okay, so I'll let you practice that. Do you want some good news? When we get to the second verse, most of it's a repeat. It's just the lyrics that change. Okay, so but practice the first verse. When you've got that, come back to me. Take a short break. Deh. Okay, you're back with me. So you've done all the hard work now. It's just a case of some slightly different lyrics and one or two chord changes. But in the main, it's the same. Okay, so we're going to go from I'm Dreaming of a White Christmas, verse 2. Starting with our C with a pinky. There's another one there for you to count. 1, 2, 3, go.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases.
Now, see what it says, slow down? That's exactly what I needed to do there. Slow down to an absolute stop. So, B, and then come back in with F plus C.
White.
Then we're going to make a minor of it. Then we're going to finish on a C major 7th. So just drop that down from there to there. May as well just use your pinky. Right, so I'm going to go from... where are we? 1, 2, 3, 4. At the end of the fourth line, may your days. Okay, so we're into line 4, may your. Starting with a C.
May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases.
Go. That's a long note on the end, isn't it? All right, so why don't we do verse 2 as it is, okay? From the beginning of verse 2 to the very end, okay? Let's do it. 4 in, pinky on C. There's another one. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, with every Christmas card I write, may your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be.
There isn't absolutely no reason why we can't do the whole piece together. Come on, let's do it. The whole lot. Starting with, you've guessed it, pinky on C. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Come on, troops, we can do it. Let's have some echo coco. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the tree tops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas with every Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be
right. So the only thing I haven't mentioned, so far we've been doing everything straight. If you've been noticed, I've been just playing with my thumb, just doing downstrokes like that. You may have been using your finger, which is absolutely fine. But, you know, you could play it that way.
I'm dreaming of a white.
Which is all very nice, but, you know, I think it goes nice if you put a little bit of a skippy thing to it, yeah? A little bit of swing. So that'll sound more like this. One, two, three, four.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.
So I'm just making it up. So I'm just going down, down, up, down now and again. Sometimes I'll go down, down, up, down, up, down. Just wherever you feel like it. It just breaks up the monotony of just doing straightforward strums like that. Okay. Now, if you've enjoyed this, there is something else which I do, which is through the Patreon website. And I have a ukulele tuition site, and it's called Ukulele Shortcuts. And it goes a little bit further than what you've been doing today. If you've managed this, you'll slot in really well with Ukulele Shortcuts. What I tend to do there is add a little bit of melody. Sometimes I need to change the chords a bit, but I could have things like this. So you've got that melody element as well, which is the next stage on from where we are today. So if you want to check out my Patreon website, Ukulele Shortcuts, have a look in the description, which is below. So everything I do for YouTube and also promoted through Facebook is completely free of charge. And I hope you're getting something out of this. If you are, please press the like. I'd appreciate that. And also with YouTube, you can do what's called subscribe. Now, subscribe of the past, if we're using that word, you tend to think of it as you actually pay money for it. I repeat, it's completely free of charge what I do for YouTube and also through Facebook. So if you want to be notified, as well as pressing subscribe, there is a little bell which you need to tick as well. And that way you'll be kept up to date when the next one will be released. And there will be another one before Christmas. So watch out for that one. So like, subscribe and notification bell. So until the next time, you all stay safe, take care, I'll see you then. Ta-ra!